Hi guys, and welcome back to another episode of The Citadel with me, Daniel M. So just going to tell you a bit about these games. These are games from the Reddit regional, this is table 4, because the lovely guys over at the Knights of Blackwater are recording table 1. So the spacing left was table 4, so this is the ones we've got. I'm not going to do all the games that we captured, just because they're a little bit old now. They're only old because I was off on my honeymoon, so unfortunately that means that these videos were slightly outdated for the meta, so I'm just going to go through them, choose the ones that I like and look off the best, and upload those. I was also using a different camera on the day to get these videos, so the quality might be a little bit different, but we'll have to wait and see. I'm a bit unfamiliar with this camera, so hopefully it all turns out alright. In this match, we have on the right Richard Walker from Northampton playing Greyjoy Crossing, and on the left, we have Isian from London playing Greyjoy Crossing. So, mirror matchup. It'll be interesting to see who gets the rush off first. I know Richard had based his deck on one that Isian had published on Thrones TV, but he'd made some of his own little changes, so we'll see if those changes make a big difference, if they even turn up. As with all mirror matches, setup and the first round can be really, really key. Because when you're playing for the same game, and when you're playing for, you've got exactly the same cards in your decks, it's a lot of the turnout of the game depends on player skill and on just what you see. So this will be quite an interesting matchup. So everyone's shuffled up, hopefully we'll move into cutting up and set up soon. So I, for the Reading Regional, just took a little fun homebrew deck. I got close to the event and realised I hadn't done enough testing, hadn't done enough playing with different decks, so I just bought a weird Land of the Crossing deck that did ran loads of Varys.
So basically, your deck is the inspiration for
the night. Yeah, and a couple of the intrigue events like Passing Rocks. Didn't go so well on the day for me. But it was a fun deck, and I've been playing it, which is why I took it, because I knew it. But there was a lot of Greyjoy, and I found that the deck really struggled against Rush for some reason. It was quite slow to set up, and if I didn't see Varys early enough to wipe the board early, I then struggled kind of as the game went on, just to keep the Greyjoy Rush in check. But that was, that was the weird thing about the Reading Regional. There was a lot of Greyjoy that I saw. There was a lot of Greyjoy, a lot of Lannister. There was some start, but not as much start as you'd expect. Obviously, Ryan won the event. You see a lot of his videos on the Knights of Blackwater channel. They've also got some great Nationals coverage going up at the minute. As I just mentioned, obviously I was just on my honeymoon, so I didn't get a chance to go to Nationals myself, but it sounds like it was an amazing time. Especially to get a chance to win those chrome-looking Night Swatch house cards. They look really nice. What I was going to do is we'll bring you a couple of the videos from Reading Regional, maybe three, four, if you get them up quickly. And then we've got moving on to a tournament where Call for Arms was just legal, and that's just happened. So if we get these videos out soon, so we can move on to a few more current meta decks. But getting into setup, Isian has made his choice. He doesn't look like he's got too many cards there, maybe two or three there. And Richard deciding what he's going to do. While they're deciding and stuff, I just want to promote it again. The final submission date for your teams for UKTC is coming up, not far off now. So if you want to come to UKTC, which is a team tournament, at the beginning of October, you need to go to the Guardians of Tyr website and get signed up. You need to submit your interest, get your fees paid, because we need to close registration soon so that we can finalise prizes and make sure that we get team name prizes sorted for the event. So as I said, we'll be closing soon, so make sure you head over that way. Ooh, so, two card setup, two four cost characters, Fionn and a Drowned Man, versus Richard, who has got, oh god, I never played Greyjoy, this is going to be interesting today.
Do you
want
to flip a coin?
The Great Kraken, Sea Tower, and maybe a Raiding Longship, with a Salty Navigator character? I think I got that right. But he's got his great Kraken, so he looks like he's got some draw there, or some power rush, which is really nice. And he's got his Raiding Longship. Now, I know Richard is a fan of rush, so the question becomes, will he do what the Knights of Blackwater have been recommending, and the podcast called Southern Bannerman? Will he just take the power and rush it out, or will he draw some cards with it straight away? We'll have to see what tactic he uses and when he decides to flip that switch. And we have got March to the Wall. Ooh, that's an interesting decision by Isian. Yes, he is Richard's board clear, but he's only losing his Salty Navigator, which he probably doesn't care about. He's feared to flip trading, so he's going to have loads of gold this turn. And Isian loses a Drowned Man. So it's a four-cost character. I know it's applying pressure. It's going to be able to force through more unopposed. But economic advantage speaking, that actually benefits Richard more than it benefits Isian. So we'll have to see how that works out. But that was an interesting decision. Isian choosing to go first. Really should have decided that before the March characters, but doesn't really make a big difference, I suppose. Isian going to have plenty of gold because he's got the three from the trading, and then he's got four from his own March Thought, and he's got just put a King's Thread out there. So that's plenty of money. The question is, how many characters is he going to be able to get out? Is he going to be able to get out something with an intrigue icon, another military power, so that he can get his crossing this turn? Ooh, gets Syria, that's quite nice. A bit more stealth, and another icon granting. Unfortunately, not really an icon that Greyjoy need. Oh, he does get our Lord of the Ships right. So, Richard immediately going, nope, I'm going to kneel this seat out so that you can't stop me using it, which is exactly what you want to do. My assumption, though, is that Isian will hold onto that Lord's Court ship right for that intrigue icon so that he can try and get his great Lord's of the Crossing trigger this turn. And I can't see what it is there. Iron Mines. He's marshalled another Iron Mines and he's holding onto one gold. So that's a good setup. It's a good marshalling phase for Isian, considering he only natively had four gold. Managing to get that King's Road and getting the Pentoshi has meant that he's got enough out there to potentially get his Lord of the Crossing. Obviously, the entry challenge is probably what he'll do first, but it'll probably fizzle because of the strength reduction. We'll have to see what Richard manages to marshal. Getting out his own Asher. But stealth is not going to do a huge amount against Isian's board, considering both Theon and Syria have stealth themselves, so she's not really going to be bypassing anyone with that. And Richard debating what else he's going to do. Paying four for that Asher because of the Sea Tower reduction.
How many cards that leaves?
Two.
Six.
And he took his own shipwright. I mean, Richard needs to get out one more character if he has any hope of getting out to his last crossing. I think on this first turn, as Greyjoy, you probably want to go second anyway. Let your opponent get some power, then the power challenge actually matters. Isian is cool. Oh, and Richard getting out the third character he needs. He gets another power icon out so that he can get all three challenges off as well if he wants. And holding on to one gold as well. So, both in I suppose Isian's board character quality is slightly better with Sirio instead of the Dragon God Priest. However, Richard has got the locations there that are really going to help him. So this means, because Isian's going first, he's going to force through a military. If Richard doesn't defend and win it, he's going to lose a character, which means he's not going to get his three challenges off. But if he, even though if he doesn't get his three challenges off, he might still get them off if Isian kneels out his whole board. He'll be able to get the unopposed with Asha, and she'll stand up, and he'll still get three challenges. So as Richard, it's hard, tough decision here. I would be tempted to let it go unopposed, lose Lord for Shipwright, and hope that Isian overcommits to trying to get his own Lords of the Crossing rather than. Yeah, perfect. So Richard let it go unopposed, hoping Isian's going to overcommit to getting his own Lords of the Crossing, allowing Richard to get three challenges off and his Lords of the Crossing, which is going to put Richard ahead in his first round. So this is the problem with going first. Yes, he's been able to force Richard's board to reduce in size, but this is going to mean that Richard is allowed to potentially get off his own three challenges. Losing a crack in his grasp to injury check claim. And now Isian needs to decide if he wants his Lords of the Crossing by using Theon. I think he's going to pass. Yeah, he's passed to prevent Richard from getting his Lords of the Crossing. Oh, unopposed. Going to get rid of the Iron Mines with a We Do Not So. Triggering Kraken to get a card. So, not getting power straight away. He's not going to rush it out straight from the beginning. He's going to eat a card to try and let him set up a little better. Ooh, and getting rid of a Raid and Longship, which is quite nice. Especially in this mirror match. Unfortunately, we can't see Richard's house card. So, we're going to have to try and keep track of how much power he's on. In my head. So we may get to the end of the game and suddenly go, oh, it's over. But we'll have to wait and see. Luckily, we can see Isian's house card. And dominance goes to Richard.
But
I guess they're in play now. Reserve. Fine. Moving into the next plot phase. I think initiative control has been really important to this round. I know Richard often likes to go second, but with that Raiding Longship he's got there, it might be good for him to go first. Really force, make sure he can force through the challenges he needs, because while he not be able to mine, he can't use Ashley's stealth. He can use that Raiding Longship to ensure that there's no point in him defending without overcommitting to his. Just a big shout out to James Lewinsky and to Tagore. Thank you for running the Reading Regional. They went really well, really smoothly. It was a very hot day, but managed to keep it nice and cool with the aircon in the venue, and it was really well run. It was an enjoyable event. Thanks a lot, guys. Hey, thank you, Richard. So we can see Richard's got one power there. On his house plot, but he has moved his plots, so it may be a little bit hard to see his plots in a minute.
You ready?
Have to wait and see.
No worries. Mirror match is always tough, right?
Just talk about how hard the mirror match is, just because you know every single trick that they've got, because you've probably got them as well. And when you're both trying to do the same thing, you will kind of bash heads quite a lot.
Happy?
I think we can see a calling the banners on Richard's side to a long winter, I think, on his side. So he's going to try and force two claim through, try and wipe out Richard's board, be a bit more aggressive. And Richard's going to get that gold for the calling the banners. So Isian obviously continuing to have better character quality for now. Richard's got those locations which are so vital to Greyjoy. Also got that economy, slight economy advantage from having played the trading and the calling the banners in the first two turns, which has meant that he's been able to recover from that setup. So Isian's going to have to really play on that sea stone, especially as Richard's got his iron mine. So this may be kind of difficult for Isian. He doesn't want to lose Theon, he doesn't want to lose Syria. So that the presence of that sea stone may force him into having to defend when he didn't want to. Obviously Richard, I think, has chosen to go first, which means that not only is he's now got the threat of the sea stone, but the raiding longship is turned on. So what the sea stone does in this build of Greyjoy Crossing is effectively enable forces your opponent to over defend things that they don't really want to. Richard probably doesn't really care about getting the sea stone through. What he probably cares about more is me making Isian have to think about not defending a power challenge because he has to over defend a military challenge. So that's going to allow Richard to rush a little bit harder. Richard also getting a House Maester and a Drownsman, and Isian just getting a Drownsman. So Richard's board presence has recovered. He's got the small characters with a lot of icons that he needs, and he's got a really good location base to support it. His board presence, I think, now has overtaken Isian's because of that calling the banners, giving him the extra income he needed this turn to help him. I really like the long plan, the long winter. I really like that little bit of extra gold that two play. However, in recent months, I think, I've really kind of gone back to Winds of Winter, that extra initiative. And not having to discard that power if you want the
intrigue
plot as a closer is really important. I understand Long Winter as a econ aggro plot, but I still
have
going more and more back to the Winds of Winter in the decks that I'm building coming up. Intrigue claim, unfortunately couldn't see what the intrigue claim was because of the glare from the store. Unfortunately, the way that the tripod was positioned for this camera, and because we were quite cramped just in this particular spot, does mean that the glare's a little bit worse than usual, so I'm sorry for that. Hopefully next set of tournaments might be a little bit better. We've opened up a new room at the club for our local tournaments. Doing power challenge, increase the drone drop, just force into a small one. And Isian's going to leave that go unopposed because of the threat of the wave of longship. And once again, his own crossing out of rough. Getting the unopposed, the claim. Is Richard going to be able to force through a unopposed military? He can force his team to over defend, but I don't think he can force him to let it go unopposed, just because he's got
military?
Yeah. Richard's just going to leave Asha standing so that she can defend against stealth and just using the drowns. Isian is going to over defend with Syria and the drowned men, forcing Isian to not get his Lords of the Crossing trigger this turn. So as I said, that's what that sea stone does in this mirror matchup, is you don't actually care about getting the kill off. What you care about is slowing your opponent down by forcing them to over defend with things like the raiding longship. So
Lord of the Crossing.
Richard has won the challenge anyway though. Because he hasn't actually used the raiding longship. I don't think there's enough warships onto The two boosts from Lords of the Crossing plus two warships does mean that it still wins their challenge. Isian choosing to kill the Drowned Men because he wants to hold onto that intrigue icon for his Lords of the Crossing trigger, which probably suggests that he doesn't have like a House Maester or a Drowned God in hand, which is kind of interesting. Getting for two claim intrigue challenge, Euron and another sustain going into it. Euron unfortunately is not a card you want to lose. A big, powerful character in the mirror matchup means he can steal the Iron Mines to protect you as well. So that's unfortunate. Isian using Theon, 3 strength plus potentially 1 for 4 strength. So unfortunately, Richard is going to lose this because of that little Sea Scout. Iron Fleet Scout? Iron Fleet Scout there at the bottom. So that's unfortunate for Richard. He's going to have to lose 2 characters, which he doesn't really want to do, especially as he's just getting his board set up. He's Lord of the Crossing triggers. It'll be interesting to see if he does have to kill 2 characters, what he's going to kill. So you're going to oppose it to prevent Theon from getting the extra power, and Isian's going to raise Theon's strength with the little warship. So Isian is going to win. And Richard is... Ooh. That's interesting. So Richard is playing the House Maester and the Priest of the Drowned God, which are actually kind of surprising. I thought he maybe claimed the Drowned One to keep the intrigue icon on the board, but that suggests to me that he's maybe got more intrigue icons in his hand, which would be really good for him. It'd be interesting to see moving into these next plot phase what we see from each of them. These boards are a lot smaller than you would normally see from crossing decks. They tend to flood the board a bit more early on. I suppose we're only just at the end of the second plot phase, but I think they've both applied kind of quite a lot of pressure here in different forms. So interesting to see what happens. This one's chosen his plot. I think I'd like to see some econ for this year. So I managed to play 2 plots that were quite fresh. I managed to stabilise his board, but I think he really needs to get a high goal plot here to force out a number of other big characters to put pressure on Richard some more. Now, I think Richard has played the long winter. And I think. Yeah, and I'm pretty sure Isian has got the trader. Which means that Richard's still going to have 7 gold and a reduction. So Isian's 10 gold. We're going to draw our cards.
All the gold in etc.
So, this is an interesting situation. Richard has still got enough economy to really recover a bit more this turn. It's just what Isian has got in his hand to how well he can apply the screws. Oh, so that's a Euron. So that's a good trading for him. That's exactly the kind of intrigue big body he needed through some challenges. Depending on... Oh, and a milk on Ashes. So Ashes not really standing up. which is quite nice for be interesting to see what Richard Murphy's in response. Getting another 4 gold, obviously. I think this seems possibly holding on to 2 gold there. He might be playing a Pitching Sword, but it seems unlikely from a rush deck. I suppose he's got the aggro elements there a bit more with the Long Winter. I think if he gives Euron Stealth for a military challenge, that will really give away if he's planning on pitching for a Pitching Sword. Ooh, I think Richard's got a Euron of his own. He does. So he had 2 in hand. He had 1 in his dupe, so obviously he wasn't too upset about seeing the dupe code. Obviously the dupe's always going to be nice, but that Euron is going to let him push 2 entry challenges of his own. And getting an Iron Mine, so he's not going to have to worry too much about playing this turn. Obviously, he's got that shed if he wants to kill it, but Isian has used as much to the wall already, so wouldn't be too terrible for Richard. He might want to do his own march next turn, force Isian to get rid of his political shipwright, but it probably doesn't matter too much. I think they're still relatively evenly matched. Their major characters now are... Isian's obviously got the advantage with the Syrio, but Richard has obviously got the location advantage. Isian going first, so Richard's raiding longship has been turned off.
Card in there you might want.
Isian just double checking there wasn't anything he wanted in Richard's discard. Is he on zero power, Richard on three? I think the fact that they've both tried to rush so much has meant that they kind of have stalled a bit. Often you will see Greyjoy by this kind of third pot phase kind of on 5-6 power already, which can be a problem. So this is going to be quite an epic battle, I think. Seeing just in the
unopposed.
Oh, claiming the Syrio. So this is literally the exact. They're seeing exactly the same cards, and he's seen claiming Richard's raiding longship. So he managed to, that pillage managed to be quite effective with 4 Euron. So he's now got his own raiding longship, which is going to be difficult for Richard. So Richard's going to want to defend these challenges even less than he was.
Give him military and stuff?
Yep.
I mean, what is that 2 gold for? Maybe he just took a marshal and anything of his own. Having given the Lord support shipwright, military and stealth. To see what happens. Military, the Lord's Court ship, right? Stealthing.
Military, stealthing drowned men.
Stealthing the drowned men.
Okay.
So trying to force Richard to kneel out something.
Stealthing Asher.
Stealthing Asher, changes his mind again. Asher, because obviously the drowned men have got the 5 strength from the 2 boats on the table. I'm not sure why he used the Lord Support Shipwright for that challenge. I know he doesn't need that intrigue icon anymore. He could have just used Syrio. I know he can boost their strength with the Iron Foot Scout, but he could just leap into defend. He gave the military anyway and stealth. They can defend the intrigue or the military for you. So I don't quite know why he just used Syrio. I think his team is leaving it there. Obviously worried about that seastone chair. I don't think there's any way Richard can really
intrigue.
Get it unopposed unless he's got a Kraken's grasp in his hand though.
Trigger.
Not got any money that I can see though. Richard's still claiming cards. I think he's maybe getting to the point where he needs to start looking at getting power. Getting 2 claims through there, which is very nice. Isian probably wanting to win the military on defence. That's probably the problem. Wanting to win the military on defence so that... Oh, Richard's got a massive choice there. Taking the King's Road, but there was a lot to choose from there. Obviously, there was the Iron Mines, there was the raiding longship of his own. So, lots to choose from, and that Euron over these next couple of turns might be putting in quite a lot of work. Taking that card with Great Kraken and managing to claim the King's Road probably means he's got something else big in his hand that he wants to get out next turn, wants to keep cementing his board dominance, rather than going for the instability of pure rush, going for the going to get board dominance and rush at the same time. He's still got the power lead, so he's probably not too worried about having to rush too hard. Getting the unopposed and getting 2 claims power. There's not 2 to claim. Oh no, he's going to draw the removal. So,
military.
And the force is trying to force through a military with Asher, but it's not going to work, because this one is going to over defend with Theon and Syrio, probably. Ah, so Asher is strength 6, defending with 6, but going to boost it up with the fleet scout 7. Richard probably could have done the power challenge with Asher and then done the military with the drowned men. Drowned men would have been strength 3, 4, 5, 7, which would have been enough for him to force through the military if he wanted. Maybe a better shout there actually, doing the power challenge with Asher. Because that drowned men have got that little bit more strength. Isian probably wouldn't have defended the power, because he probably still would have. Maybe he would have defended the power, so Richard wouldn't have got the unopposed, he would have won the military, so he would have got his Lord of the Crossing trigger. Yeah, losing the Lord of the Crossing trigger and 2 flame to get the unopposed, probably not worth it. Moving to the next court phase. Reached in 6 power, like while he hasn't, while the locations have given him an advantage, he's been going second, so the raiding longship hasn't been turned on. He's been getting cards with the Great Kraken, which you can see with his fist full of cards is leading to an advantage. Isian, after that 2 claim intrigue, is now behind in cards, so he's 1 in hand, so he's going to be kind of reduced to top decking. So Rish Isian is going to start running out of steam here if he's not careful. So in response, he's going to try and keep, apply the pressure with the Rise of the Kraken. And Richard playing Rise of the Kraken as well. So Isian obviously going to get to choose because he's got less power.
You go first?
I'll go first.
Yeah.
And Isian is taking Richard first, which is interesting with the 2 players. Obviously Isian wants to try and get off his own unopposed. Or maybe he wants to be able to defend against Richard's 2 flame military challenge. He doesn't want to take that to the face. But that's going to be difficult for Richard with the raiding longship. I'm imagining Richard could get through a challenge with Euron, take the other raiding longship, and then use that to get through 2 more challenges. So maybe a dangerous situation for Isian.
How many cards
have you
had?
4.
V2.
Little finger. Trigger his reaction.
Using the King's Road and the
Pokemon. Okay,
get even more cards, and he's got another intrigue item. I think a lot of this is going to, with this game, is going to depend on how Isian decides to defend this turn. And whether he's just stalls, or if he takes it to the face, to see what he can marshal. I think he probably wasn't expecting Richard to play another 2 claim this turn. I can't imagine he was. Isian has gone first here to be able to use his own raiding longship. Sorry, interesting position. Which has got enough claim there to defend his own. And Isian is going to use the Lord's Watchship to kneel out the raiding longship, which is a difficult shot. Because he's got another one! And I think that's it. So Richard has to push through a challenge with Euron if he wants another raiding longship. But we'll see what challenge order he decides to do it in. The 2 flame won't hurt his team too much now because he can kill both the Lords for shipwrights.
Intrigue.
Okay. Richard doing intrigue. Which just seems to defend what happened. All he has to do is defend and win it with Euron getting renowned.
just getting your pillage, being able to take another location for Richard. This means Richard can get through a power challenge with you on kind of without too much hassle. Isian taking a goal Rose Road, obviously thinking this game, he's going to try and drag this game about a bit longer, so that extra economy is going to help him. Or maybe that was the only location in which he's just going. I can't remember seeing any other locations. Not too much else to choose from.
So, three.
Richard obviously got two miniature planes to think about in return. He does have an Iron Mines though. He can steal another Iron Mines off the scene if he wants. Personally, I might have maybe pushed through the intrigue with Euron and Littlefinger. Stolen an Iron Mine for a raiding longship to help with playing or help push through some more challenges. Rich is just going to do a single little chuddy power challenge. Isian's going to have to defend with Theon if he wants to win this. Which is then going to allow Richard to maybe push through a military quite easily. Interesting shout though. I'm going first. Seems to have quite handily muted Isian's 10 challenges in return. Not much else to do. Isian probably wants to leave those three characters standing to try and get off his own challenges. So probably doesn't want to defend this, but he's kind of going, nope, can't let you get that unopposed, that two unopposed, and two power from me. I'm surprised Richard didn't use something like Asher, trying to force that power challenge. I suppose Isian has only got one power, so the claim's not really going to do a huge amount for him. Richard doing a military challenge with Euron. This is debating letting him get the unopposed potentially. Probably doesn't want to give him that too power. He's going to get renowned anyway. He's going to get his Lord of the Crossing trigger. Could be a big swing for him. And Isian unfortunately having his Rise of the Club muted by the pressure that Richard is applying. Yeah, Isian going to let it go unopposed. Wants to try and get through his own military challenge.
Into it when you gain power from an unopposed. Oh yeah, okay. Well, you can start control it. Okay. So, Lord of the Crossing. Two for unopposed.
Two for unopposed. Two Lord, one for Lord of the Crossing. Did you take a card for the Great Dragon? Really? I thought he'd want to get the power.
Trigger the Seastone Chair.
Trigger any Seastone Chair. I'm obviously probably going to. Oh, killing Gyoron. Obviously, that's the better character to kill. But I'd be tempted to kill Sirio just to get rid of the character for this turn, prevent him from lots of locations there to choose from, force him to so he can't get through a military challenge this turn. He's going to be able to defend it with the Drowned Men or Asher to win it. Isian can't use his raiding longship, so I suppose he's not a threat. I suppose the military challenge isn't a threat. Richard can defend and win it. And is he going to do a two claim intrigue? Getting to an opposed, getting to power. Getting rid of Euron and. Ooh, the reader! So more draw. Richard has probably still got a fistful of cards though, so not a huge worry for him. And is he going to force him? Kneeling. military stealthing Asher. So forcing Rich to defend it with the jam ring, which he can do. I know. Wonder if we see he's got crack in his grasp. Yeah, crack in his grasp.
Only if you're the first player.
And Richard remembering it's only if you're the first player. So he can't do it. I think that's one of the reasons why Richard is such a good player. He remembers the little details of cards really consistently. And when he's making decisions like that, he remembers when things, certain things will and won't work. So I think that's one of the things that makes him one of the better English players at the minute, is just his attention to detail. very rarely misses really important English lesson. So Richard is 3 power off, I think. By the looks of it. So we go 10, 12, yeah. Richard's 3 power off. I think he's won this game at this point. Don't think there's anything the Isian can do. He's run out of cards in his hand. He's run out of options. Getting that draw off the Great Kraken has really given Richard the steam that he needed to force through this.
I will be the first player.
Richard played something with higher initiative than Isian. Maybe weapons at the door with 3 gold? I can only see the side of it. I think it might be weapons at the door. And Isian playing Wildfire to try to level out the board a little bit more. Having lost his Euron, he's in a dangerous situation. Richard has to debate about what he wants to lose. Going to lose the little finger. Richard, I think, is going first. Would be my assumption, because I think he can force through his 3 his challenges quite easily this time.
Challenge.
Have an action. Nearly sacrifice. King's Road. What else has he got in his hand? He's just seen all the characters. That draw from Great Kraken. Okay, I'm sorry, guys. Southern Bannerman, I don't think you're right. I think the draw has won Richard this game. I think if he'd been claiming power, he might have got there quicker. But the draw, if he'd taken the power, he might have got there quicker. But the draw has absolutely cemented his win in this game. I don't know if you're right about taking the power every time. And Richard having gotten Balin out, this game is well and truly over. I don't know what Isian can really get out to come back in this game now. Is that Nashor? It's helpful, but not amazing. No? Changing his mind? Chris the Dragon got instead. Isian, I think, a little flustered here. Coming up against basically your own deck. And he's put him in a dangerous position. Kneeling out the way of Longship to make Richard's math a little bit harder for him. Going to be able to force through an intrigue with Euron here. Yeah, and Isian realizing it's game there. Unfortunately, he could defend it, but Richard was going to get Renown there. He was then going to get through an unopposed military with Balon, and he was going to get through a power challenge. Yeah, just over in a blink of an eye. Quite a long game, quite thoughtful, but actually we didn't get that many shots in. Early on, it was really evenly matched. I don't know if Isian gave Richard back his raid and longship. Not entirely sure. Richard just commented that he prefers fealty for Greyjoy. That Lords of Crossing really does force your challenge order, and it really forces kind of your deck building a bit more. But it worked out for him in this game. So, guys, thanks for joining us today. See us for some more games. I'll cherry pick a few more from the Reading Regional. If I don't show your games, I'm really sorry, but obviously it's a bit boring. So, yeah. And I'll see you guys next Tuesday. Bye.